Service teardown. OMEN by HP 15-DH0000 Laptop PC. Removal. Remove the 6 6mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the base enclosure to the top cover. Starting with the rear edge, carefully separate the edges of the base enclosure from the top cover. Remove the base enclosure. Reverse this procedure to install the base enclosure. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure. Warning: to avoid personal injury and damage to the product, use extreme care not to puncture, twist, or crack the battery. An internal puncture or rupture to the battery has the potential to cause a short, which may result in a thermal event. Removal. Disconnect the battery cable from the connector on the motherboard. Remove the 4 4.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the battery to the top cover. While supporting the battery with both hands, lift the battery off the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Important: when replacing the battery, a new thermal pad must be installed onto the new battery before the base enclosure is replaced. Reverse this procedure to install the battery. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure. Removal. Disconnect the battery cable from its connector on the motherboard. Push both arms outward simultaneously to release the memory module to the spring tension position. Grasp the memory module by the edges and pull gently to remove it. Reverse this procedure to install the memory module. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure. Removal. Disconnect the battery cable from its connector on the motherboard. Remove the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the solid-state drive to the motherboard. Remove the bracket from the solid-state drive. Grasp the solid-state drive by the edges and pull gently to remove it. Reverse this procedure to install the solid-state drive. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure. Removal. Remove the Mylar that covers the wireless module connectors. Caution: use care when disconnecting the wireless antenna cables from the wireless module. A damaged cable or connector can degrade notebook performance. Carefully disconnect the wireless antenna cables from the wireless module by grasping the connectors with a small pair of needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Remove the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the wireless module to the motherboard and allow it to raise to the spring tension position. Grasp the wireless module by the edges and pull gently to remove it. Reverse this procedure to install the wireless module. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure and battery. Removal. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the hard disk drive ZIF connector and disconnect the hard disk drive ribbon cable from the motherboard. Remove the 4 3.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the hard disk drive assembly to the top cover. Lift the hard disk drive assembly off of the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the hard disk drive assembly. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, and hard disk drive assembly. Removal. Important: make careful note of the routing of the speaker cable for later replacement. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad button board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad button board ribbon cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the motherboard. Peel back the Mylar that secures the speaker cable to the top cover. Remove the speaker cable from the routing channel on the top cover. Remove the 4 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the speakers to the top cover. lift the speakers off the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the speakers. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure and battery. Removal. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbon cable from the touchpad board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad button board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad button board ribbon cable from the motherboard. Remove the touchpad button board from the adhesive that secures it to the touchpad board. Remove the 5 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the touchpad bracket to the top cover. Lift the touchpad button board off of the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the touchpad button board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure. Removal. Disconnect the battery cable from its connector on the motherboard. Disconnect the DC in cable from its connector on the motherboard. Remove the DC in cable from the routing channel on the motherboard. Carefully release the DC in module from the retention tabs on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the DC in module. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, wireless module, and DC in module. Removal. Disconnect the right fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Remove the wireless antenna cables from the routing channel on the fan. Disconnect the left fan cable from the connector on the motherboard. Remove the 4 4.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the fans to the motherboard. Note: the thermal module has numbers adjacent to the following 6 screws. Remove the 6 4.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the thermal module over the processor components in numerical order. Note: due to the adhesive quality of the thermal grease located between the thermal module and the processor components, it may be necessary to move the thermal module from side to side to detach it from the motherboard. Carefully lift the thermal module off the motherboard and remove. Note: before replacing the thermal module, the thermal grease should be replaced. The thermal grease should be replaced every time the thermal module is removed. Reverse this procedure to install the thermal module. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, wireless module, DC in module, and thermal module. Removal. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the card reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the card reader board ribbon cable from the card reader board. Remove the 3.5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the card reader board to the top cover. Lift the right edge of the card reader board off of the alignment pins, slide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the top cover, and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the card reader board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DC in module, and thermal module. Removal. Important: make careful note of the routing of all the cables for later replacement. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the card reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the card reader board ribbon cable from the motherboard. Disconnect the speaker cable from the connector on the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard backlight ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard backlight ribbon cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad button board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad button board ribbon cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the power button board ZIF connector and disconnect the power button board ribbon cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the motherboard. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the thermal sensor ZIF connector and disconnect the thermal sensor ribbon cable from the motherboard. Remove the three 3.5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the motherboard to the top cover. Grasping the motherboard near the center, lift the left edge off the alignment pins, slide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the top cover, and remove. Note: before installing a new motherboard, remove all components from the old motherboard and install them onto the new motherboard. Reverse this procedure to install the motherboard. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, and motherboard. Remove the two 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the power button board to the top cover. Lift the power button board off the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the power button board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, and motherboard. Remove the 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screw that secures the thermal sensor board to the top cover. Lift the thermal sensor board off the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the thermal sensor board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, and motherboard. Removal: important, make careful note of the routing of wireless antenna and display panel cables for later replacement. Remove the wireless antenna cables from the retention tape and routing channel on the top cover. Remove the display panel cable from the routing channel on the top cover. Grasp the top cover near the display panel hinges and open the display panel hinges. While supporting the top cover, remove the four 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the left and right display panel hinges to the top cover. Slide the top cover off the display panel hinges and remove. Note: before installing a new top cover, remove all components from the old top cover and install them onto the new top cover. Reverse this procedure to install the display panel assembly or top cover. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, motherboard, and display panel assembly. Removal: carefully separate the inside edges of the display bezel from the top, sides, and bottom to disengage it from the display enclosure. Important: the edges of the display bezel are held in place with adhesive. Take care when removing them from the display enclosure. It may be necessary to use a non-metallic, flat-bladed tool to aid in the removal. Lift the display bezel off of the display enclosure and remove. Reverse this procedure to install the display bezel. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, motherboard, display panel assembly, and display bezel. Removal: peel back the retention tape and disconnect the webcam cable from the connector on the webcam board. Using a flat, non-conductive tool, carefully remove the webcam board from the adhesive and alignment pins that secure it to the display enclosure. Remove the webcam board. Reverse this procedure to install the webcam board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, motherboard, display panel assembly, and display bezel. Removal. Peel back the retention tape that partially covers the left display panel hinge. Remove the three 2.5 mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the left display panel hinge to the display enclosure. Lift the left display panel hinge off the alignment pins on the display enclosure and remove. The right display panel hinge is removed in the same manner. Reverse this procedure to install the display panel hinges. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, wireless module, hard disk drive assembly, DCN module, thermal module, motherboard, display panel assembly, and display bezel. Removal. Important. The display panel is held in place by two strips of stretch release tape. Each tape strip has a plastic pull tab attached to one end. One at a time, grasp the pull tab of each strip of tape and carefully wrap it around the end of a cylindrical tool, such as a screwdriver. Slowly twist the tool to release the tape. Continue twisting until the entire strip has been removed. Important: if the stretch release tape strips are pulled too quickly or at an extreme angle, they will break before releasing the display panel. Note: the removed stretch release tape is not reusable. Remove the display panel cable from the adhesive that secures it to the display enclosure. Peel back the retention tape and disconnect the webcam cable from the connector on the webcam board. Lift the display panel off the display enclosure and remove. Important: please refer to the maintenance and service guide for instructions on replacing the display panel. The stretch release tape strips that secure the display panel to the display enclosure must be placed in a specific orientation